Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss Brimonidine. What is this drug Brimonidine? This drug is available in the form of an ester tartrate. So this Brimonidine tartrate is one of the alpha 2 adrenergic receptor agonist. This drug can be used as eye drops in the treatment of glaucoma where there is increased intraocular pressure resulting in the blurring of vision, increased pressure and pain within the anterior chamber of the eye, which if it is untreated, it may result in the loss of vision. So in such conditions, Brimonidine can be given to reduce the intraocular pressure. Similarly, this drug can also be used to control the ocular hypertension where there is increased blood pressure in the eye resulting in the increased pain and redness of the eye. Again, in such conditions, Brimonidine can be given as eye drops to reduce the ocular blood pressure. And here we can identify the suffix nidine. We have similar drugs like clonidine, apraclonidine. All of these drugs are alpha 2 adrenergic receptor agonists. But here Brimonidine is having somewhat more specificity and it is considered as third generation alpha 2 receptor agonist. So, Brimonidine is more selective towards alpha 2 receptors compared with alpha 1 receptors. That's why this drug is more specific in the treatment of glaucoma as well as ocular hypertension. So, today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. Now, let us see how this drug acts. Within the eye, sympathetic system plays an important role. Now, adrenergic neurons store one of the important neurotransmitters, that is the norepinephrine. This norepinephrine can be released and it can act on postsynaptic neurons which are equipped with adrenergic receptors such as beta 2 receptors. These beta 2 receptors are excitatory in nature, resulting in the sympathetic stimulation. So, when the action potential reaches to the presynaptic neurons, norepinephrine can be released and it can act on beta 2 receptors. So this results in the excitation leading to increased formation of aqueous humor. So within the anterior chamber of the eye, aqueous humor is more collected, resulting in the increased intraocular pressure. So this may result in the impaired vision, double vision, blurred vision, and finally it may also lead to the loss of vision if it is untreated. So beta 2 receptors play an important role in production of aqueous humor. But this sympathetic stimulation is controlled by alpha 2 receptors which are located presynaptically on the adrenergic neurons. Now, Brimonidine is one of the drugs which acts as alpha 2 receptor agonist. So, it can bind to these receptors resulting in their activation. By activation of alpha 2 receptors, they can inhibit one of the pathway, adenylyl cyclase pathway. So, when this adenylyl cyclase is going to be inhibited, ATP is not converted into cyclic AMP. So, cyclic AMP levels are going to be reduced within the presynaptic neurons. In absence of cyclic AMP, calcium channels cannot work properly. So, calcium cannot enter into the presynaptic neurons. So, it cannot produce any exocytosis. At the same time, the potassium channels are going to be activated. So, potassium can go outside, resulting in the hyperpolarization of the presynaptic neurons. In this way, presynaptic neurons are inhibited, resulting in the decreased release of norepinephrine. So, when the norepinephrine is not released, it cannot stimulate the beta 2 receptors. So, this leads to decreased production of aqueous humor. With the decreased sense of aqueous humor, along with its improved drainage, the intraocular pressure can be reduced within the anterior chamber of the eye. So, this results in the relief of symptoms in the patients with glaucoma. In this way, Brimonidine is going to inhibit the sympathetic stimulation, which also results in the decreased ocular blood pressure. So, this drug can also be used in the treatment of ocular hypertension. Now, let us see the precautions. One of the important precautions of Brimonidine is that this drug can produce some vascular insufficiency. So, in the patients with already any vascular disorders, this Brimonidine should be carefully given. So, this drug may increase cerebral insufficiency, coronary insufficiency resulting in the poor circulation within the brain as well as to the systemic blood vessels, which may impair the functionality of many of the organs. Similarly, brimonidine should be carefully given in the patients with any symptoms of depression, where the depressive symptoms are further increased with vascular insufficiency, and in the patients with any Raynaud's disease, where small veins are going to be blocked so that the blood is not going to be pumped into the heart. Again, in such patients, brimonidine should be carefully given. And in the patients with any orthostatic hypotension, this drug may produce the hypotension, resulting in the increased falling sensation. Or in the patients with any thrombotic angiitis, where the blue discoloration of the blood vessels supplying to the fingers can be observed due to formation of thrombosis. In all such patients, this brimonidine should be carefully given. What are the side effects? The important side effects are locally observed within the eye. So it can produce some burning sensation, stinging, ocular hyperemia, resulting in the redding of the eye. It can produce some headache, blurring of the vision. It can also produce some oral dryness. Even ocular dryness can be produced. Ocular pruritus. It can produce some itching sensation within the eye, which persists for some time after the administration. And other side effects include fatigue, ocular staining, and muscular pain can be observed with this brimonidine. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of brimonidine. Here you can observe a 6+6 membered ring system. So let us give the numbering. We can start the numbering from this nitrogen. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now simply this ring is the quinoxylin ring. So we can write the suffix as quinoxylin. Now to this quinoxylin, at the 5th position bromine group is present, so 5-bromo. 6th position amino group is present, 6-amino. But to this amine, this ring is going to be attached. This ring is nothing but imidazoline ring. So we can write this as imidazoline 2-I. That is a complete name of brimonidine. How it is given? This drug is available as eye drops or ophthalmic solution at a strength of 0.2%. It is also available as 0.15%. Even it is available as a gel formulation, where it can be applied on the skin to reduce the facial erythema. As eye drops, it can be used in the management of glaucoma and ocular hypertension, where the dose of the drug is given as one drop in the eye 3 times daily. So that's about this brimonidine tartrate, which is a more specific alpha receptor agonist compared with clonidine and apraclonidine. So this drug acts locally on the eye, where it is going to reduce the sympathetic stimulation within the ophthalmic neurons. Thereby, it can reduce the formation of aqueous humor stimulated through the beta-2 adrenergic receptors. Even this drug is not acting on the beta-2 receptors, but it can inhibit the release of norepinephrine by acting on presynaptic alpha-2 receptors, which are inhibitory in nature. So by inhibiting the sympathetic stimulation, it can reduce the formation of aqueous humor, as well as it can also reduce the blood pressure. So it can be used in the treatment of glaucoma as well as ocular hypertension. But this drug should be carefully given in the patients with any vascular insufficiency, as this drug reduces the blood pressure and it can impair the circulation in such patients. So that's about this drug, brimonidine tartrate. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.